The following symptoms indicate that the dosing valve is blocked. Drop dosing is not possible. Dosing jet is deflected. Satellite drops are produced. Drop contains air bubbles. Drop volume is incorrect. Dosing valve leaks. Drops form on the valve outlet. If any of these symptoms occur, clean the affected dosing valve. Required tools: waste vessel, sample vessel, rod magnet, valve wrench, disposable syringe, plastic needle, and isopropanol. Before you begin cleaning, put on safety glasses and safety gloves. Step 1. Remove the dosing valve. Make sure that no cartridges are present in the pressurized dosing unit. Turn the MSA or DS3252 module upside down. Unscrew the dosing valve using the supplied valve wrench. Remove the valve. Step 2, cleaning procedure. Fill the supplied syringe fully with isopropanol. Push the thin side of the valve hand tight into the plastic needle, and push the other end of the plastic needle onto the filled syringe. Position the rod magnet parallel to the valve. The magnet will open the valve. Move the rod magnet several times along the valve. Push half of the isopropanol in the syringe through the valve into a separate waste vessel. Immerse the valve in a sample vessel filled with isopropanol and gently pump the syringe at least 5 times in both directions. Discharge the syringe until it is empty. Fill a clean sample vessel with isopropanol. Fill the syringe with isopropanol and push it through the plastic needle and the valve into the waste vessel until the syringe is empty. Note: if the isopropanol cannot pass through the valve or be pulled back up, or if the liquid flow out of the valve is not straight, then the valve is probably extremely contaminated. Place the valve with the rod magnet attached in a sample vessel filled with isopropanol, and place the sample vessel in an ultrasonic bath for at least 30 minutes. Step 3. Remove the isopropanol from the valve. Use a clean, dry syringe and a clean, dry plastic needle. Push the thin side of the valve hand tight into the plastic needle. Pull air into the syringe and push the open end of the plastic needle onto the syringe. Use the syringe to push air through the needle and valve 10 times. Always remove the plastic needle and valve before pulling air into the syringe. Step 4. Install the valve. Screw the cleaned valve hand tight into the instrument using the valve wrench. Step 5. Test the cleaned valve. Connect the MSA or DS3252 module to a computer. Test the drop dosing with Advance. If the pressurized dosing unit still does not function correctly, repeat steps 1 through 5. Test the valve again. If the dosing process is still not optimal, contact your technical support for a valve replacement.